What is metformin? Metformin is a prescription drug that is used to treat high blood sugar levels that are caused by a type of diabetes mellitus, or sugar diabetes called type 2 diabetes. Metformin belongs to a class of drugs called biguanides antihyperglycemic agent. This product is available in the following dosage forms: Metformin immediate release tablets, Metformin extended release tablets, which are available as the brand name drugs Fortamet and Glumetza, Metformin hydrochloride oral solution, which can be used in children from 10 years of age and adolescents. What is metformin used for? It is used in conjunction with diet and exercise for glycemic control in type 2 diabetes mellitus. It is also used off-label for insulin resistance in polycystic ovary syndrome. Metformin can be used alone or with other diabetic medications such as sulfonylurea, or with insulin to help lower blood sugar level when it is too high. Modest weight loss is another well-known advantage of this medication, making it a good option for obese people with type 2 diabetes. How does metformin work? With type 2 diabetes, insulin produced by the pancreas is not able to get sugar into the cells of the body where it can work properly. This condition is known as insulin resistance. This leads to high blood sugar levels. Metformin works to correct this problem by reducing the amount of glucose made by your liver, decreasing the amount of glucose your body absorbs, and by increasing the effect of insulin on your body. What are the side effects of metformin? The following are some of the more common metformin adverse effects: nausea, abdominal pain, diarrhea, heartburn, and gas. Sometimes metformin may result in serious side effects that are a medical emergency requiring immediate medical attention. Hypoglycemia, or low blood sugar, is the first one I'll talk about. Symptoms that indicate you are having hypoglycemia include headache, weakness, drowsiness, dizziness, irritability, sweating, fast heart rate, confusion, and hunger. Metformin has boxed warning, which was formerly known as black box warning. This is the highest safety-related warning that medications can have assigned by the Food and Drug Administration. These warnings are intended to bring the consumer's attention to the major risks of the drug. Though extremely rare, you may develop lactic acidosis, a dangerous buildup of lactic acid in your blood. Symptoms include weakness, unusual muscle pain, trouble breathing, unusual sleepiness, stomach pains, nausea or vomiting, dizziness or lightheadedness, and slow or irregular heart rate. This is a medical emergency that requires treatment in the hospital. Lactic acidosis is fatal in about half of people who develop it. You should stop taking this drug and call your doctor right away or go to the emergency room if you have symptoms of lactic acidosis. Low vitamin B12 levels is the other serious side effect of using metformin, and the symptoms include muscle weakness, low energy, loss of appetite, and tingling or numbness in the hands or feet. How to take metformin? Follow your doctor's instructions for taking metformin precisely. Read all instruction sheets or medication guidelines that come with your prescription and follow them exactly. Periodically, your doctor might adjust your dosage. Follow the medication's instructions to the letter. The general starting dose for adults is 500 mg daily, which can be increased to a maximum of 2 grams daily. Take metformin with a meal, unless your doctor tells you otherwise. Some forms of metformin are taken only once daily with the evening meal. Follow your doctor's instructions. Do not crush, chew, or break an extended-release tablet. Swallow it whole. Measure liquid medicine carefully. Shake the oral suspension before you measure a dose. Use the dosing syringe provided, or use a medicine dose measuring device. In the event that you experience extreme hypoglycemia, your doctor might recommend a glucagon injection kit. In case of an emergency, make sure your family or close friends know how to administer this injection. Metformin is just one component of a comprehensive treatment plan that may involve diet, exercise, weight management, routine blood sugar testing, and specific medical attention. Follow your doctor's recommendations exactly. What if you miss a dose? If you miss a dose, take it as soon as you can. If it is almost time for your next dose, take only that dose. Do not take double or extra doses. What are the contraindications on the use of metformin? Besides its broad indications, metformin remains contraindicated in many conditions associated with hypoxemia because it can lead to lactic acidosis. Ketoacidosis is one of the contraindications when using metformin. Insulin therapy should be started in type 1 diabetics and type 2 diabetics with severe hyperglycemia and ketoacidosis. Metformin therapy for type 2 diabetes can be initiated if the patient's glycemic values are balanced and if there are no additional contraindications. In type 1 diabetes, metformin is solely administered as an adjuvant because it can reduce the insulin requirements. Chronic kidney disease is another contraindication. Metformin should not be used in patients with an estimated glomerular filtration rate or calculated creatinine clearance lesser than 30. Cardiac failure. If patients develop congestive heart failure or concomitantly have other contraindications or acute diseases, metformin should be stopped. Hepatic impairment. Metformin-related lactic acidosis has been reported in patients with hepatic impairment. This may be due to impaired lactate clearance resulting in higher lactate blood levels. Therefore, individuals who have clinical or laboratory evidence of hepatic impairment should not use metformin hydrochloride tablets. Respiratory insufficiency. The FDA and EMA advise caution should be taken since the risk of lactic acidosis is increased in individuals with altered blood gas exchange, such as in restrictive pulmonary diseases, asthma, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, surgery and other procedures. Withholding of food and fluids during surgical or other procedures may increase the risk for volume depletion, hypotension, and renal impairment. Metformin hydrochloride tablets should be temporarily discontinued while patients have restricted food and fluid intake. Excessive alcohol intake. Alcohol potentiates the effect of metformin on lactate metabolism. Patients should be warned against excessive alcohol intake while receiving metformin hydrochloride tablets. In pregnancy, metformin can be used in diabetes but should be guided by a specialist diabetologist or an endocrinologist. Metformin may interact with other medications. Metformin can interact with several other medications causing different effects. This can interfere with how well a drug works, while others can cause increased side effects. Diabetes drugs like insulin and glyburide. Low blood sugar levels can result when taking metformin with several diabetes medications. Your doctor might lower the dose of the other diabetes drugs you're taking if you start taking metformin. Cholesterol drugs such as nicotinic acid. If you take metformin and nicotinic acid together, your blood sugar may not be reduced as effectively. Blood pressure drugs like furosemide and hydrochlorothiazide. Diuretics are used to decrease blood pressure. However, they may also raise blood sugar levels. Metformin's effectiveness may be hampered by taking these medications at the same time. Glaucoma drugs like acetazolamide, brinzolamide, dorzolamide, and methazolamide. Your risk of developing lactic acidosis may rise if you take metformin along with glaucoma medications. Hormone drugs like estrogens and other drugs like corticosteroids. Metformin may be less successful at decreasing your blood sugar if you take it along with some hormone medications. Phenothiazines drugs like chlorpromazine, fluphenazine, and prochlorperazine. When used with the antipsychotic drug phenothiazines, metformin may not be as efficient at lowering blood sugar. Topiramate. You run a higher risk of developing lactic acidosis if you combine metformin with topiramate, a drug used to treat seizures and nerve pain. Combining these drugs is not advised. Isoniazid. Taking isoniazid, a drug used in the treatment of tuberculosis, with metformin may make metformin less effective in lowering your blood sugar. Phenytoin. Metformin may be less effective at lowering blood sugar when used with the seizure medication phenytoin. And that's all for this video about metformin. If this video has been helpful, please smash the like button, share it, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Until next time.